Hi there, we're going to talk about how to move your email into OneNote so you can save any important email that you want right within your OneNote notebook. So the first thing that you want to notice is that right now I'm in my email for Connie at Mission Computers, and when I'm in my inbox and clicked on an email, there's a send to OneNote button on the home ribbon way over on the right side here. If I go to a different email account, like info at Mission Computers, go to the inbox there, notice that when I'm clicked on an email and I'm still in the home ribbon, there's no send to OneNote button. So there is no button if I'm using a different account than I use to get into my Microsoft account. But I can still drag emails, and I'll show you that in the second example here. So let's go back to the inbox for Connie at Mission, and let's take this email here, and I'm going to open it up. And while this email is open, I'm actually just going to hit the send to OneNote button. So notice on the right side here, I have all my notebooks showing, as well as recent sections that I might have visited. So I want this particular email to go into my classroom notebook. And then I need to pick which section it should go into. So I want it to go into my example section, and we'll say class examples. So that's as far as you can go. It's going to make an actual page for this email. So I'll choose class examples, hit save. Okay, I can open in OneNote, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to minimize this and let you see my OneNote. So class examples, working from home, this is the email you just saw me send from Outlook into OneNote. All right, so that's example number one. Now the next example I'm going to share with you is, let's just keep OneNote open, and then let's go back to Outlook, and let's just make Outlook a little bit smaller so I can see my Outlook and my OneNote on the screen together. So I'm going to just turn off this reading pane. And as I was mentioning earlier, I can't save an email from a different email account with the button, but I certainly can save it into OneNote if I just drag it. So I'm just going to go in my OneNote. So I'm back over here on my OneNote. I'm going to go to my email example, and I'm going to take one of these emails from Mike from Keep, and just drag that email way over into my notebook. And I've got two choices when I drag it. I can insert it as an attachment or upload it to OneDrive and insert a link. Let's try attachment first. So attachment is just kind of like an attachment in an email. It's actually attaching this email to my OneNote. It's making a copy of it. So the actual original email, if you notice, is still in my Outlook. And this one is an actual copy. So if I double click on this email, it opens it up. So I'll close it there. If I double click on this email over here in Outlook, it's the same email. Okay, now I'm going to get rid of this email in Outlook, because the whole point of you moving an email into OneNote is not to keep a second copy of it there, but to actually lessen your email overload in Outlook. So we're going to delete this email. And that's the idea. We want to delete these emails so that we can actually have them somewhere more value to us. Now you may not like the look of all these little email attachments, so drag and drop might not be your favorite thing. That's where this one that we did earlier, working from home, this one's kind of neat because it put the whole email in there. But let's take a look at the third option that we had. So I'm going to go back to email example here. And the third option was when we say drag it over here. So let's just drag this other one from Mike. It says upload to OneDrive and insert link. So if I choose that, then what's happened, I'm gonna make this bigger. Okay, it says it's upload has been scheduled. So what's happened is it's actually put that email onto my OneDrive, and the link will now appear in my OneNote. So it's actually not taking up any space in OneNote, it's taking up the space in OneDrive. But again, it's still something that I can then delete that email from Outlook, because I now have a copy of it in my OneDrive, and that link is showing in OneNote for me. So if I look at some of the other examples here, pivoting in crisis, this is one that I linked earlier. So if I click on that, that'll open up the email, and you see that it's coming from my OneDrive actually. So here's the email opened up from OneDrive from the link that I have in my OneNote. So I'm going to close that. Pivoting Crisis is the link that I use there. Okay, just announced the Keep Campaign Builder workshop. So that's the one that I just dragged in here a minute ago and it said it was uploading. So let's click on it now. And this is what it looks like. Not the greatest looking thing. I mean, it is converting that HTML email into what it considers to be the right look here. So it's making this graphic very big at the top, but the text is certainly down here. So here are your choices. You can drag an email in and have these little email attachments. You can link an email to your OneDrive and have that link to go back to. I guess that depends on how much graphics is in that original email. And then you can also take that email and actually use the button in Outlook to put it in as a full email in Outlook. So I'll just show you that button again in Outlook. Sorry, so it was a full email in OneNote. So if I go back to my Connie at Mission Computers and I click, and now I can delete that email, by the way. So let's say I want to take this email and send this email into my OneNote. I'm just going to open it up. Send to OneNote. It is showing me my class examples as one of my recent sections, so I can just choose that and save. That was a section within my classroom notebook. And then we can go to OneNote and take a peek at this. A fast growing startup, and it's taking that graphic, making it a bit big, so I'm just going to delete that graphic. And you see that we have the rest of it showing quite nicely with the hyperlinks intact. Okay, so I mean, your other option for taking information out of Outlook and putting it into OneNote is certainly to do some copy and pasting, meaning that you'd open up an email, you do the copy, select everything, choose copy, let's paste it onto this page in OneNote, and that's what that looks like. We're not getting the email sender information with the time and date and all that, but we are getting the gist of the email anyways. All right, so hopefully that helps you get some idea of your options that you have for taking emails that you have in Outlook and putting them into OneNote so you can get those emails out of your inbox and into a place that's going to be more organized for you long term. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.